maisha, maisha si rehaso. Maisha ukianika uwezi unakaso. Wala uwezi unafuta. Kuna vitu fulani unavifana ndani ya maisha yako, alafu baadaye vinakuja perfect. Either positive or negative. And this being your favorite show, your story, with your favorite host, Chacha Evara. Tunamgeni ndani ya nyumba. Tunamgeni kwa show. Ambaye ni Nelson Mandela. Amekuwa huku sana. Unajua venye anajitanga? Anajitanga. What? Ama leopard. Ama joy kwa Kiswahili. Ni kwa nini anajita hivyo? Ukitaka kujua ni mambo gani ambayo Nelson Mandela amejipitia, amepitia ndani ya maisha. Ukitaka kujua what ni nani ama serikali ni nani. Ungana nami on the other side of the show ili tuweze kujua Mandela ni nani.
Like you've heard, I am Mandela Nelson. I am named after one prominent leader. On a chilly morning on Thursday, 28th March, 1994, Mandela Nelson was born in a village of Homa Bay, that is Homa Bay Town Constituency, Homa Bay County. The name Mandela was given to me after the hero, the former president of South Africa, may his soul rest in peace, Mandela Nelson. I was born one day after he was declared the president of South Africa.
Oh, wow. So which year was this?
That is 1994.
Yes. So bro, maisha yamekuaje tangia primary mzee, maisha shule na maisha nyumbani, maisha chakula nini, wazazi walikuwa vipi?
Unajua nikikumbuka primary school sometimes I become emotional. The life back in primary school some was hectic. That is in the year from 2002, that is when I set foot in class 1. The worst moment is there. I repeated class 2. That is after garnering 67 marks out of 700 with 08 in GHC and CRE. I became number 51 out of 51 and I repeated class 2 with flying colors. And that is where I started picking up. So life was not so that smooth. I remember by that time, if you could have a bag calibrated or returned back to school, then that was very big achievement. In fact, your family were considered to be the haves in the society. Another thing, we were in the Moi era. That was the end of Moi era, where every parent was supposed to be responsible for everything. I remember we used to sit on the stones, and the haves in the society of the school would come with their desk. And so when you sit in their desk of somebody, then you have to attach something. It's like you give them a daily token. Kenda kununua sukari nguru lazima umpe, otherwise utafukuzwa kwa hiyo kiti. Life was also very hectic, then we were having things like the bag ilikuwa ile inashonwa na gunia, you can imagine. Ile mzazi alikuwa anaenda kwa soko, soko yetu ilikuwa anaenda soko mjinga, anaenda ananunua hiyo bag ya 20 bob. Bab ilikuwa 10 bob, so imagine she has 20 bob, she buys you two bags, imagine. So unaambiwa if you try to be number 1, 2, 3, ndio utanunuliwa bag ile inaitwa daso ama bag to school. And though here you are Papua Mandela, you cannot even get 20 in mathematics. So you will be forced to stay with the bag until you complete your class 8. So hectic was the life in primary school.
So vipi mambo ya chakula, nyumbani?
Actually, I was traveling for a long distance to get primary education, and we were going there barefooted. The only achievement that your parent could give you was to put on a sandal called akala.
Akala.
Made of the wheels of a car.
Otero.
Yeah, you call it Otero. So that was the only achievement. If your father or your mother could be in a position to purchase for you slippers, you would put them in ships. You put a slippers here, then you walk 3 steps, you remove them so that they didn't get worn out very fast. It was so fun in that life, you see. Then also we would take long hours traveling to school, then some extent you go back home, the parent has not prepared anything, you're forced to go to the jirani kukula, you're also chased away, so it was not that very easy.
Oh, so even though maisha ilikuwa mdela.
Maisha ilikuwa hivyo, but I thank God we adapted.
You adapted. You adapted,
yes. But having been born in a family of around seven, and I was the first born, so I had to...
Of seven. So bro, mniambia maisha yako ya shule ya msingi, primary, lakini sasa kuna hii part ngumu sasa ya secondary school.
Tunaita kwa Kiswahili shule ya upili.
Shule ya upili.
Actually, shule ya upili was, in fact, it acts like the periphery of learning, where you meet all the challenges that you are supposed to be undergoing while in school. The first challenge in high school was like, I was a day scholar. So I come from the lake region, go back home in the afternoon, I'm forced to go get water, I go fish, at least to generate some income to help me cater for my fees, because I was not the only child. Some others were following me, so I had to work hard, at least get a token for mandazis in the morning, and at least pay things like remedio. So that was the hectic part of it.
Ni kitu gani ndani ya secondary school ambacho kiliwahi kilikufanya ukafili nimba sahihi ukafili njinga, unaona kitu gani ambacho kilikufanya ukafili maisha ya shule yananilemea?
Actually, I remember one moment in high school, there is a time I spoke in mother tongue, and so I became a consistent mother tongue speaker. So the first punishment was that you were to be sent home to buy books. I was buying that frequently because my classmates loved me so much. And so, yeah, storybooks. I speak in mother tongue today. You think of punishing me by sending me home in the evening. They have contributed a token for me. I buy a book. So that was not working. And so they had to send me home. I took a period of 2 weeks there. And then I came back. I found after people have done their cuts. And so I had to adjust. That is one of the hardest moments I had in high school. Another one was that, actually I had three. Another one was in Form 2. You see, in Form 2 there is this what is called late adolescence. Then you feel that you should be who and who in the school. And so that is the moment that I was thinking that I was very bright. Actually, I was challenging teachers. I would read ahead of them and then I would challenge them.
Asking questions.
So there is a time we had a teacher on TP. She was a madam teacher on TP. And so she came and started teaching us. And then there's a time I raised my hand and I said, no, Malimu, you are teaching us irrelevant things. These things are not adding up and you are not best to teach us. And so that was in geography in Form 2. We were tackling internal land forming processes. And so the teacher sent me out of the class for 2 good weeks. And the 3rd week that I was supposed to report back was the week that we will do cut. And so that is the time that I said that this madam want to know who I am. She must know Mandela is who. I started reading. I read because of the teacher. I was not reading because of the energy I had for the subject, but I was reading for the teacher. To embarrass her and tell her that I can do well without her. And so when the right time came back that I was admitted back into the class, I came and sat for the cut. I got 29 over 30. Instead of appreciation, I was caned with everybody in the Department of Arts and the Humanities, because they were saying that I had the brains and I was joking. And that is the point that I started saying that geography is mine. And up to now, if you go to the school, geography, I still lead the history. Geography in high school, geography in Maasai Mara, I still lead the mantle. That was another moment. The worst moment was when we had the school ball games from other high schools coming. Then after you had spoken mother tongue so much, you will be punished. You will be given a gunia, a white gunia, very clean white gunia. In Andiko Apa, I am a fool, I can't speak in either English or Kiswahili. Yeah, you're forced to put it on. So in Andiko Apa mbele na nyuma. So unatembea now, I am a fool, I cannot speak either in Kiswahili or in English. You can imagine. So there was this lady I met during the ball games. So I could not hide. This my beautiful white dog was also embarrassing me. I was trying to influence the lady in the Queen's language, that is in English. But then behind me was a calibration that I am a fool, like I neither speak in English or Kiswahili. That was the worst moment, and the lady in purity said that she could not
work and do away with a self-declared fool.
That was the worst one.
Story yako noma sana.
Kabisa. Niliona mingi sana high school.
Vipi kusikula shuleni ya mkwa mnastambulia high school mda wote?
Sasa hiyo hata mkubwa, hata wewe. That is an exclusive story. It was a survival for the fittest. You will go there and struggle for the food as if it was prepared for you. Personally, Mandela, the only thing that could send me out of the DH was the clearance of the sufuria. In fact, the nilikuwa nangoja yoshwe nione kama iko safi ndo nijue chakula imesha. Na utoka DH chakula imesha. Without that, you could not convince me. I knew that chakula and DH were another subject. I was doing 7 plus chakula and DH was 8 subjects. And so you could not, and it was a core subject. So you could not.
Yo,
I could not avoid such problems. You see, if that was my best subject.
There are people who survive.
Yeah, that was my best subject. And so the worst moment in that my subject where I failed was when I was caught red-handed. I was trying to push a mono.
Form one,
a confused element by then to get away so that I get my second chance. And that is when Mr. Nyori, the deputy head teacher by then, grabbed me. I was placed amidst everybody. Remember, it was a mixed school. Nililazimishwa kukula mchele, my friend. Mchele kafu bila hata supu. Iyo doya 20 liters hiyo kifuniko yake yote. Nililazimishwa kukula. Na ulikula. Na niliambiwa usipomaliza ni kiboko. So I had to avoid kiboko na ile aibu ya wasichana kuona ati. Yeah, and then you also, in this high school, you have to also work at to identify your potential being. Yeah, the female potential being somewhere. And so I struggled so much to eat. Ilikuwa inaninyonga na kakamua. So the deputy principal thought I could not do it. By God's grace,
you did it.
And by the power of Mandela in me, I emerged victorious. Instead of the teacher letting me go, he punished me because I embarrassed him. That was opposite of the expectation. So that was how hectic life was in my school. But I thank God I managed.
So bro, menambia maisha yako ya nania shule ya secondary. Hey, natisha baba.
Hey, bana huko. Lazima you want to survive.
Yeah, like, so, ni mwaka gani ambao ulifanya KCSE?
I did my KCSE in 2014, where I passed with flying colors.
Then you were called?
I was called to join Maasai Mara University to pursue Bachelor's of Arts in Criminology and Technology.
Hapo umebobea.
So I changed, actually I changed, I don't do that. But I'm now blaming myself, I would have become an ICID. I think it makes it, but I'm now, I'm a teacher.
You're a teacher.
I'm a teacher. I say I'm a teacher by birth. I'll go by profession.
Kwa hiyo ulivyokuja chuo kikuu hapa campus, unajua huko campus sasa ndio unakuwa mwanaume. Sasa unapitia zile real life situations.
Ukauka nini?
Unajua hapa kwa mwanzo unalala njaa mda mwingine. Vipi ulipofika campus? Vipi challenges gani ambazo umezipitia?
Actually, I was admitted in Maasai Mara University on 7th Tuesday, 2015, September. I was admitted to pursue that Bachelor's of Criminology and Penology, which I told you I changed. I was given a room in Loita B201. That is where I stayed with our good, nice people. We were staying there, 6 people. So you remember our times, people used to pass. They knew how to pass the examination. So we were 6. The number was so high, and so we were to stay 6 people. Life was there, was so good. Sometimes it was very bad.
Umewahi patikana hostel na kitu fulani ambacho kufanya kesi fulani?
Actually, I count myself one of the lucky students in Maasai Mara. After being given a room in Loita B201, I also got a chance to stay with the student leaders down there in the circle there. Student leaders like Patrick Gessa, the former finance secretary, Evan Souya, the former president, Kinsey, the former deputy secretary general, Wesonga, the former sports director, Bokelo, the former entertainment director, and Don Paul. And so I had a glimpse of how to survive with people. The only point that I got a problem was when I started bringing Big Mandela in Loita B201. I started cooking omena at lunchtime.
And you're not supposed to?
Yeah, it was the regulations were that you are not supposed to cook.
Omena
in a nuclear. So I also got a way of surviving with this omena. So I could cook this omena and work with a sufuria of omena hiyo harufu yote across hiyo the floor of to something so that you confuse the janitors. So napika tu one there hapo kidogo kidogo nakimbia na hiyo yote. So janitors hautapata imepikwa wapi.
Hautajua ni gani.
Hautajua ni wapi na happy. So that was the first time. The second time wakakuja. Wakaanza kuniambia wewe kijana fungua, nikafungua mlango. Wakanipata nikipika na koi, wakaniambia pika, wakapata ugali iko kwa moto na umeona ishaiva. Pika na tupatie sufuria na kila kitu. Wakaningoja hapo hivi. Mimi tu nikakuwa na ujenga nikapika. That moment nikapea jama wangu alikuwa anaitwa Kelvin Kiro mkali. Nikampia kwa griffis, nikaingiza sufuria, nikaangusha coil kwa dirisha. Nikamwambia toka na coil. Toka na sufuria na kila kitu. Ugali tumeacha hapo. So jamaa akatoka na masufuria kwa briefcase hivi. So unajua jamaa wanangoja. Janitors wanangoja kwa mlango nimalize niombe masufuria na coil.
Akapita kwa huo mlango.
Yeye akapita tu nikawa si unajua obvious tu ni mtu anaenda class. So obviously they were waiting for mimi Mandela niombe. Kumbe jamaa mapita na masufuria na akaenda akachukua coil. Within 3 minutes akambia get in. Akambia chukweni kwenye tuliona. Chukweni. Wanasema kijana si ulikuwa unapiga hapa na coil. Akambia take it. Take it, you've been disturbing my peace. Yeah. Na hiyo mena nimenunua hapa nje na ugali. Yeah. You can't disturb my peace. Lunch is nature and you can't disturb nature at lunch time. Unakuja unaniambia nikupea mena yangu. You see walienda.
Walienda. Nimeshinda kesi.
Nimeshinda kesi. Hakuna evidence. Hakuna ati oh nimepika mena na nini hakukua. But in actual, so they pointed my route. That is why nikahama nikaenda huko chini. Vision of your goals as one by one.
Kwa hapa shule. Mambo sasa tuingie sasa. Unajua hapa shuleni sasa chako wanaongea. Wanadada wamekuwa shida sana hapa.
That is another
competition iko juu. Ushawahi ku heartbreak wana dev?
Actually
wewe ni Mandela.
Yeah, Mandela
ni quatch.
I am quatch. So you see, whatever I can now say is that most of the campus relationship are as a result of peer pressure. Like kila msia kuna dem room na wewe unabaki hapo peke yako
wewe
bwana unaachapo exile kila mara bwana uko na mzee room bwana anakuambia bwana umeenda kula mzee anakuambia eh hello Mandela branch wifi niko na mgeni every day bwana niko na mgeni bwana
eh
hey, hello branch wifi
yeah.
So unasema ah mimi lazima at least mimi nitafute kama mwingine ni branchishe wazee pia wifi at least
kuna wifi pia
so hiyo mimi
nitapata
on 13th September the same month, when I was walking from Suswa Hostel, I met a very nice, curvy, and mattered lady. A college lady, and you remember, you know what is matter. Luos, we love matter. Anything that occupies space and has got mass. And so I was obsessed with this matter. And so I blushed. She smiled back. That is when we exchanged our contacts. I had a Nokia Asha 200, and almost she had a Ikaduga. So we fell in love. Hivo tu pole pole tu, hivo tu. So you know, she was also trying to control me. I was also very influential in first year. I had a long hairstyle, so I was very conspicuous. Yeah, with 3 pens on both sides. Uko tatu. So I was very conspicuous. You will say, this is Mandela. This is Chacha. So, tukajaribu kupendana pole pole. I invested all my heart in this lady. Unaona? Ile tu naambiwa high school soma. Wachana na wasichana. Kuna wasichana kampo. Huyu nikakuta nikapata mbele ya the former main hall. Tukapendana. Which will never get out of my heart. 26th September, my friend. 2015.
Hata mwiza kuhisha mzee.
Sat. Nani usiku. It was our freshest night. Iliisha. See, the lady was so common. She would land on every man. Eh? The bachelor, like bachelors of landing on every man's chest rhythmically. And so I was very jealous. You see, I have been keeping myself to meet this lady, the precious one, in campus. Then she started entertaining people, kissing and showing, because she was tipsy then. Kissing people and entertaining would die. So I decided to fight. I could not do anything, my friend. The guy was very gigantic. He was a bodhia. And he was a lawyer, you can imagine. Now, mimi niko bodhia na bojana hivi. So imagine kama niko first year, 1 GP. And I could not face that man. So I had to also hire some goons and also to fight the guy.
tukapigana
the same night.
Yeah, the same night, the same venue, the same time. Tukapigana nikamrusha huko na huyo mwanaume wote wajaluo alisaidia kupita. Ikaisha hivyo. The following day akaniambia it is over.
Yeah.
Ilisha, my friend. After that, she started moving on. And also, there is this point in the relationship that you want your ex to know that you can live without her.
Yeah, yeah.
And also, she wants to know that you can live without you. That is the worst point in a relationship. You see? That is the worst point in a relationship.
She has to show you that
yeah,
she's moving on.
Yeah, and also, nilikuwa natafuta, at least, I want to
replace.
Yeah, replace.
I want to see mwanamke bwana.
My brother, my brother on 13th.
Yeah. The following month.
No.
September.
13th
of July. July. The following year. Following year. Also, that's a serious heart.
This one. Hey. Reasons best known to me. That was the second heart. I started moving on. You see, I want to tell those people I'm moving. Yeah. And also got this very precious Kamba lady of which we broke up on 13th February 2017.
So,
2 days to Valentine.
Aye.
Satano Asubuhi, I was in Form 2 and we were on a long holiday and I was marking geography before one.
Yeah.
Ended like that. So relationship life in Maasai Mara and campus general is very heavy.
It's a scam.
It's a scam.
Love in campus,
and thus I decided to be in love with philosophy. I decided let me be a philosopher and a politician. It can save me. Actually, that
girls, girls change like
girls, it depends with the weight of your pocket. Yeah,
yeah. Hey, MJ, what are
you doing from MJ?
Sir, you're a heartbreak. I'm a heartbreak. I'm a heartbreak. I'm a
heartbreak. I'm a heartbreak. I'm a advisor. I give people advice in relationship. Because I have a long time experience, a better life experience.
So, bro. Tumeona kwamba huko shuleni wewe uko famous, una biashara, unajua kuna wenzetu sisi kama sisi tunatamani sana kuwa na biashara hiyo. Kupata kazi. Unajua kuna mwingine nyumbani hana hela, unapiga simu. Imagine wewe mwanaume mzima hivi una debt unachukua simu kupiga mzee. Sawa. Baba shikamoo, mimi sina hela.
Aki unajua mzazi atakumbia tu pesa lakini anaona like this child hawajibiki kama.
Yeah, ni mwanaume.
Yeah, to start with being social, being a celebrity, it's also good, especially in an environment like this. It's also good and challenging. For if there is a problem, let me say there is a strike, you have to also pack yourself and take a chance. Students expect you to be at the forefront and fight for them. Administration or anybody is also looking at you. So you have to make a concrete decision.
So how did this come back on Amiliki Bishara Shuleni?
Legally, the tenders belong to the school. And the school gives them to them. Students fraternity, and so under the SOMU, that is the organization that bounds every student in Maasai Mara University. Once that is done and a new body is elected into office, they advertise their tenders. After advertising their tenders, they do what? People apply, then the successful applicants are invited into the interview. After which, I had a team, I did all my things. One trait that is good in me that I know God blessed me with is that I am a go-getter. I'm a go-getter, I know what to be done at what time and to get what. My dad once told me that my son, have a patience of a vulture. Unaona vulture hata ikisimama huko juu imeona kakifaranga haina haraka. Hata ikiona tu hata simba ikikula ndama imeuliwa saizo. Itangoja mpaka ikule, mpaka simba iende, mpaka ile kaka zibaki, ndio itakuja kubeba. That is always my trait. I always have that patience. And I know what I go for. Pole pole, na inaenda iko. And so I prepared my application that could merit whatever I wanted to do. And that could be satisfactory to the team. I presented it. In fact, I was the best. Out of the 18 people who applied for the hotels were 4. And remember, 18 people were fighting for the same position, and I was number one. That is why I got to take number one. I knew what to be done at what moment. This is how to convince the panel. This is what to be done. How to bring everybody involved. How to source finance. And so when I appeared before the panel, everything was ready. And that is why I got to this.
What's the name of your
hotel? Actually, my enterprise is called the Big Fish Hotel.
Big Fish Hotel. Why you call it?
Actually, the term Big Fish is metaphorical.
Yeah.
I told you I'm in love with philosophy. The Big Fish means, in layman's language, it means that there is something which is bigger than the other. And so I call myself the bigger fish. In the business phenomena, I branded myself to be the big. Let others diminish themselves, but I call myself the big one. Yeah. So if you go back there, you look at my business here, you will see that everything is big, from the space, the variety of foods that are being prepared, and also Mandela in this school is also big. Right. So yeah, it is metaphorical. I like big things. I prepare things in big quantity, and also see how to.
So,
yeah, I also expect to harvest big. Actually, I can say that nategemea watu for advice.
Mtu kifedha.
I sort myself out. Size, in fact, people wanna nitegemea. People depend on me. Very many people, some of them students, parents, friends, and even relatives. Yeah, they depend on me.
That's not very good.
I can also depend on people when it comes to finances. I have a financial constraint. I run for you, Chacha, or I run to my friend Prince somewhere. I tell him, Prince, you know what? At least, Prince, I'm running out of cash. Prince, my friend, do what? Give me something, Prince. Man, give me something to boost my business.
So, bro,
yes.
Your story has been so nice. Karibu sana. Tumeshukuru sana kwa wewe kuja kwa show. Tumesikia story yako itajenga watu. So unajua tena?
Yes.
Yeah, bro. So, thank you so much.